under threat from four major fires.
Home and a nature and wildlife retreat.
Massive wildfires.
The fire is burning, the wind is strong and everywhere around
here. The devastation of bushfire.
The impact of bushfires on communities, on homes, on lives.
We're in a biodiversity crisis. Biodiversity has been declining. It's declining decade on decade. The number of extinctions is continually increasing. So we should be very worried. We should be taking urgent action. We really think there has to be critical changes. We have to make them now, because once the species is extinct, you cannot get it back. I'm Don Driscoll. I'm Professor of Terrestrial Ecology at Deakin University. Most of my research is about conservation biology. So I'm interested in the ecology that helps us understand how we should better manage plants and animals in the wild. The biggest threats to biodiversity include land clearing. Invasive species have really big impacts, but now we've got much more frequent fire and they're becoming more widespread. We've changed the amount of fire in the landscape, and that's really making species vulnerable to decline. Because the fire risk is increasing due to climate change, potential response of land managers is to increase the amount of planned burning that we do. This poses a real risk to biodiversity. Recent research suggests that as climate change becomes more extreme, the planned burning will become less and less effective. We really do need to think carefully about how much we invest in planned burning versus alternatives to managing fire. Cultural burning is going to be an important part of the mix of managing fire into the future. As an ecologist, to me, the real advantage of cultural burning is that it's putting the right fire into the right ecosystem at the right time, taking into account the series of seasons that have come up to that point as well. It's a way of applying fire that's in tune with the ecology of the landscape and what it needs and when it needs it. Wherever it's been practiced around the world, it usually leads to biodiversity benefits. Completely different to the way agencies do planned burning. When the fire comes along through an area that's had frequent fire, there are no places for animals to escape from the flames. And after the fire, there are no sort of charred logs left for them to shelter in. And that leaves them exposed to predators. Some species need long periods of time between fire to recover enough so that they can withstand the impact of the next fire. Biodiversity is really important for our human health. There's lots of research now showing that exposure to biodiversity increases our resilience and health outcomes. We get the vast majority of our medicines from nature. Every species that goes extinct is another option that we don't have in the future. I think mammals are more vulnerable because they're larger, because they're warm-blooded. This really makes our mammals the most vulnerable group to these kinds of megafires. After the 2019-20 bushfires, there was a massive investment in monitoring to find out what happened to our plants and animals. Through our project, I knew that there were a whole range of other similar projects going on at the same time. And I saw this as a major opportunity to really find out what was modifying the impact of the fires on wildlife. I jumped in and said, look, let's do this. We got a small grant from Deakin to kick it off. And started working our networks to gather as much data as we could. Our projects involve picking sites using satellite imagery. We wanted to pair sites, so we wanted sites that were burnt near to sites that were unburnt. And with the invertebrates, we went out to sites particularly focused on mountaintops, because individual species have evolved on particular mountains. So they've been isolated on these mountaintops and evolved separately from the one on the next mountain range. Other researchers used a whole range of different techniques. So there were bird surveys with people walking around with binoculars. My colleague used a giant net on top of his car to catch flying insects. So there's a range of clever techniques used. We've already seen governments moving to include biodiversity in their fire management plans. So we saw the amazing example of protecting the Woolloomy pine during the 2019-20 fires. And we saw governments moving in to protect bristlebirds and move them out of the path of the fire. We need to think strategically about how to create unburnt patches within our landscapes. What I hope is that my research is able to reach a broad audience, to help inform policy, to rein in climate change and to better manage wildfires.